Hi, I'm Stefania from SweetSpot.ca. I'm about to go in and interview Sammy Hagar, who's not only a legendary rocker, but also knows a lot about tequila because of his Cabo Wabo brand. So I'm very excited not only to meet him, but learn a little bit more about what's been my new favorite drink after getting about halfway through my Cabo Teeny.
Everyone's experience in the old days with tequila was with rot gut tequila, and they still make rot gut tequila. Just the premium tequilas are really taking off. Patron, Cabo Wabo, Don Julio, the three biggest brands that have really changed the way people think about tequila. And the reason I started making my own tequilas because I built a club in Mexico called the Cabo Wabo in Baja, and I said, I want to have my own tequila. It's going to be a tequila bar. And I went to the town of Tequila, and I tasted the most fantastic handmade boutique tequilas, and it changed my life. And I said, I'm going to change everybody's life with this, and that's really how it started. Well, never mind about Rocket. It's only 51% tequila. It's called Mixto. It'd be like a can of concentrated orange juice, right, and with sugar in it, and all kinds of other stuff, chemicals to preserve it, and just mix it with water. Right? That's what you're drinking. And wood chips to make it gold, not put it in a barrel. They put wood chips in there and then filter them out. You know, stuff you'd barbecue with.
Right.
It's pretty much up to your palate, but I can tell you that you kind of look for, if you do salt first, believe it or not, I really believe in this, sea salt or kosher salt. Don't use the ionized salt. And you just put a little bit on your tongue, or one of these guys, and clear your palate, because if you've been chewing gum or something minty or something, have you been eating spicy food, if you've been eating tacos and salsa, then you don't need to do all that, especially if you're eating chips and salsa. It's great, great with tequila. So anyway, so and you smell it and taste it. The first thing's going to happen, you're going to taste it kind of sweet. It's going to taste like kind of honey, and then it's going to turn kind of to kind of citrusy, or kind of vegetables, like kind of earthy, grassy vegetables, like a wild vegetable kind of smell. If you cut them with a lawnmower, you get a little bit of that. And then you'll end up always with a little bit of salt and lime without doing it. It tastes like a real good tequila. That's what it's got. That's why you use salt and lime with it, because it goes well with it. So it's and then it'll taste like tequila, and you'll usually go, that's part of it. The shivers are part of it. Well, Blanco is just pure tequila, and if it's rot gut, it is really rot gut. That's the most rot gut, because it's the wood, like I say, when you put wood, put it in a barrel or put wood chips in it, kind of smooths out, absorbs some of the impurities, and you get a smoother taste, to where a bad Blanco is bad. A great Blanco is awesome. If you really like the taste of tequila, you're usually a Blanco fan, because it just tastes like tequila. And the longer you leave it in wood, the more it becomes like an Armagnac or Cognac, which some people love aged tequilas. I'm not a huge fan anymore. First time I tasted a 3-year-old tequila, I thought I died and went to Mexico, man. I went, this is the greatest thing I've ever had, So it did turn me on to it. But then as you go backwards, you start going more towards a Reposado, which has been aged for 3, 6, 8, 9 months even, some of them, smooth them out a little bit, but you still got that tequila taste, and that's what we're looking for. If you want to drink tequila, drink tequila. Yeah, well, it's what happens. You stop thinking once you do about 4 shots. The brain goes, I'm having a good time. Yeah, man, you're on the table, and then I can't tell you how many people have slept in my dress room with the Cabo Wabo. Okay, here's to the second half of the night. Ha 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 ha!